particular topic and subject, also you will find that there are different opinions in regards to this subject. What is this subject? This is the position of music in Islam. The position of music in Islam. What is the legal Islamic ruling on the use of music, making of music, listening to music? You will find that with many other issues like music, there are different opinions. There are some scholars that will give you their understanding, their fatwa, where they will permit and they will allow the use of music. Some will give you a ruling, a fatwa, that they will totally prohibit music. Those that allow music also do not allow music completely. Even they, when they say music is permissible, they mention certain conditions. Those who say music is absolutely haram, absolutely forbidden, also these scholars do exist. They have their own understanding based upon their own evidences and proofs. One thing we must all understand, first of all, the first point, is with many rulings in Islam, you will see difference of opinion. With many rulings of Islam, you will see scholars having different opinions. Some who will say this is permissible, some who will say this is not permissible. The first thing what you need to understand, what you need to believe is that if someone has their opinion based on proof and evidences they have, whatever their opinion is, you have no right, absolutely no right, to think that you are better than the other opinion, or that your opinion is the best opinion, or your opinion is the only opinion. And you have to accept the diversity in the Ummah. You have to accept the intellectual diversity, academic diversity, that within Islam you will have certain rulings, you have different opinions. So this is something that we must understand. Whether you are agree with the scholar or you don't agree with the scholar, whether the Mufti, he presents in front of you proof and evidence, you agree with it or you do not agree with it, you must accept that diversity and you must have other. The problem of today is that when we realize that someone has a different ruling or someone has a different idea, someone has a different ideology than ours, without research, those people of less ilm, people who have less ilm, little knowledge, you will see them the most angry, the most aggressive, with the most aggressive attitude. Those who have a lot of knowledge, a lot of wisdom, despite they may have different opinion, yet they will not be aggressive towards them. They will say, okay, that's your approach, but we disagree with it. Simple as that. And this is the approach of the scholars, that when you see on any particular issue two opinions, and you have one opinion, don't consider the other opinion wrong, or the other opinion, don't be aggressive towards it. Don't be abusive towards it. Any aggressiveness is one thing. I have seen people who are abusive. They say, no, this is absolutely wrong, absolutely haram, you are going to hell. And they become abusive. They do not realize that on this particular matter issue, there is difference of opinion. So we must say that we accept the diversity in the Ummah. Music is also one of these topics and subjects. On the use of music, there are scholars, as I said, that they permit or they allow music in certain conditions with restrictions. And there are certain scholars who absolutely prohibit the use of music and listening of music. So I would like to present today to you my own research on that, my own understanding on this subject, on this matter. When we look at music, first of all, we must understand music usually consists, or when you hear about music, people say music is haram, people say music is allowed. Normally, music consists of two things. Number one, it consists of singing. It consists of what? Singing. And number two, it consists of the use of musical instruments. So you have singing and you have the use of musical instruments, two things. I would like to discuss and I would like to view this particular research step by step. The first, let us discuss singing. What is singing? Singing is the use of your own voice, melodious voice. To use your own melodious voice, to sing something, some text, this is singing. In regards to singing, there is two things. Number one, the text that is being sung. The text. What is the text? What is it? It could be either Quran. Quran is text also. Either it could be human man-made pure poetry. Text made by humans. It could be divine words, divine text, or it could be man-made text. When it is divine, then this is always good. Text divine, there is no question on divine text. Kalam of Allah. Yes. Yes. Yes, that's fine. Kalam of Allah, divine Kalam of Allah, is always positive. Kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no question and no debate, no discussion necessary on it. Whether it is hasan, it is good, or it is not good. Kalam of Allah is Kalam of Allah. You read one haraf, you get 10 good deeds. This recitation of the Quran, how one should read the Quran. There is a very beautiful hadith and this explains to us. Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrates, Imam Bukhari records this. Sayyidina Abu Hurairah narrates, قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لَيْسَ مِنَّا لَمْ يَتَغَنَّ بِالْقُرْآنِ. The Prophet said, that person is not among us who does not sing the Holy Quran. And he not read. Here the Prophet is saying, the person who does not use melodious voice and does not sing when he reads the words of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَيْسَ مِنَّا لَمْ يَتَغَنَّ فِي الْقُرْآنِ. The person who does not use ghina, any melodious voice, but recitation of the Quran, he is not from us. And the Prophet has encouraged, has recommended a person not merely to read the Quran, but when you read, read with a melodious voice. Read with, like this, like you are singing. So to use melodious voice and to sing the Quran, the Prophet ﷺ has not just allowed, at the same time he has encouraged, recommended, and he has stressed and emphasized on it. لَيْسَ مِنَّا لَمْ يَتَغَنَّ بِالْقُرْآنِ. The person who does not use melodious voice in recitation of the Quran, he is not among us. رَوَاهُ فِي الْبُخَارِ. So to use your melodious voice with the text of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, kalam, it's perfectly fine. It is absolutely recommended in Sharia. Now the next step. There is text that is not divine. Man-made text. In regards to poetry, you must understand the Prophet ﷺ was once asked about poetry or text that is used by people singing. And Aisha, Sayyidah Aisha narrates, radiallahu anha, قالت زكر عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الشعر. She says, in front of the Prophet ﷺ, someone mentioned and someone asked about the position of poetry, position of text, man-made text. What is its position in Islam? And the Prophet ﷺ said, فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ هُوَ كَلَامٌ حَسَنُهُ حَسَنٌ وَقَبِيحُهُ قَبِيحٌ. The Prophet, peace be upon him, differentiated. And he classified the text, poetry, in two different types. He said, هُوَ كَلَامٌ, that is kalam, that is poetry, which either حَسَنُهُ حَسَنٌ, it is, if it is good, then it is good. And if it is qabih, evil, wrong, then it is qabih and evil. Which means the Prophet ﷺ classified poetry, man-made poetry, between good and between evil. Between good and evil. Here you must understand one thing. The good poetry. What is good poetry? Poetry in which Allah is praised. Poetry in which the Prophet ﷺ is praised. Poetry in which, for example, people mention positive things. You are celebrating your anniversary. You are celebrating your birthday. You are thanking Almighty Allah, narrating text to thank Allah that Allah gave you children. Allah gave you a house. Allah gave you a blessing. Allah gave you independence. Independence of your country or your nation. Any such poetry is considered to be hasan, good. So in regards to that, the Prophet ﷺ said it is permissible. It is good. And on the other hand, the Prophet ﷺ said that poetry that is evil, that which is, what is evil poetry? That poetry that talks about haram, that talks about relation between man and woman, haram relations. That poetry that in you will inspire and motivate you to evil, to the path that will deviate you from Islam. That poetry that will make you forget Almighty Allah, Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, your salat, your fara'id towards Allah, that poetry which will indulge you in dunya, any such poetry, huwa qabih, that poetry is qabih, is evil. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam distinguished, classified, and makes a difference between good poetry and bad poetry. Any poetry, like today, you listen to certain Hollywood or Bollywood music where they are talking about the shape of the body of a woman, where they are talking about to enjoy life and to a whole night sing and clubbing and all these things. Obviously, that is absolutely, the poetry is haram. The poetry is qabih. Is qabih. The Prophet said is qabih. So when a person is evil, when a person listens to evil, obviously he is haram. But he said certain poetry, hasan, is also good. Which poetry is good? We all know what is haram, I don't need to tell you that. What is allowed? Here, very interestingly, you will be surprised that when you study Islam, you will understand that the Prophet ﷺ, when he said good poetry, sometimes we see examples of Sayyidina Hassan ibn Thabit radiallahu anhu, the great poet of the Prophet ﷺ, standing in front of the Prophet and saying, Ya Rasulullah, wa ahsanu minka lam taraqat 'aynin wa ajmalu minka lam talid an-nisa khuliqta mubarra'an min kulli 'aybin ka'annaka qad khuliqta kama tasha. We see Hassan ibn Thabit writing or singing poetry text in which he praises Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet ﷺ does not prohibit, does not discourage him. In fact, the Prophet ﷺ encourages him by giving him his own shawl. Another example of good poetry. A Sahabi in the time of the Prophet ﷺ got married. And the Prophet ﷺ found out, did you get married? He said, yes, Ya Rasulullah, I got married. The Prophet ﷺ then told him that what kind of marriage is this? He said he got married. The Prophet said, what kind of marriage is this? And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, قال Rasulullah, أعلنوا هذا النكاح. Go and announce this marriage. This marriage of yours that you have done, you have not announced it. أعلنوا هذا النكاح. Go announce this marriage. وجعلوه في المساجد. واضربوا عليه بالدفوف. And go and announce and sing. And use the foof, yani use musical instrument, daf, which is drum, you can say. Use the drum in the masjid. The Prophet ﷺ not only allows, he orders, commands him. أَعْلِنُوا هَذَا النِّكَاحِ وَاجْعُلُوهُ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ وَضْرِبُوا عَلَيْهِ بِالْدُفُوفِ. The Prophet ﷺ said, go in the mosque and sing there and announce there your marriage through singing and the foof. It means through drum, the use of music. Here the Prophet ﷺ has not outside, in the house of Allah, he has allowed good poetry. Which poetry? That Sahabi was not going to say, was not going to speak about the Prophet. The Prophet said, go announce your marriage. Which means he was going to say, he was going to sing poetry about his marriage. Maybe about that Allah blessed him that he completed the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. That Allah, that he has completed half of his faith, Iman, for example. Prophet ﷺ did not tell him exactly what to say, but he said, go and al-ilan, do the announcement of your marriage. And he did not say, use this text or use that text. Any text he was using to announce his marriage with the daf, it was considered to be not only permissible, the Prophet ﷺ recommended and commanded him to do so. So here you see good poetry about marriage. This hadith that I just narrated to you about nikah is amazing because it is in Tirmizi, Imam Tirmizi narrates. Imam Tirmizi also, and Imam Nisai and Imam Ahmad, they narrate another hadith which is about nikah, marriage. They said, مَا بَيْنِ الْحَلَالِ وَالْحَرَامِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمَ said, the Prophet said, مَا بَيْنِ الْحَلَالِ وَالْحَرَامِ الصَّوْتُ وَالْدَفْ فِي النِّكَاحِ. He said, the difference between halal and haram, the difference between a legally valid nikah and a nikah that is not legally valid. In haram, what is it? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الصَّوْتُ وَالْدَفْ. It is voice, melodious voice and musical instrument, daf. It is Imam Tirmizi narrates. So the Prophet ﷺ allowed the use of singing of poetry. And then, as I said, poetry text is classified as either good or either bad. Any text that is, that will deviate you from the path of Allah and the Prophet ﷺ, that talks about shaitan, that talks about any act of shaitan, haram. Any such text is haram, and the use and the singing of that text is automatically also haram. But any text that has nothing to do with shaitanic activity, it is general, mentions nature, mentions anything neutral and natural, that text is permissible. Not only permissible, you can use it with singing also. Now, so when we talk about music, as I said, there is two things. There is the singing of text and there is the use of musical instrument. Now comes a little bit delicated, and this is a little bit more controversial. The use of musical instrument with that singing. Here you see, the use of musical instrument with the singing, here you see the difference of opinion among scholars. Here, up to here, the scholars will say yes. Everyone up to here agrees. Everyone up to here unanimously agrees with what I said. The use of good text and sing without musical instrument, they always say yes. But when you involve musical instrument, then you must understand then there is difference of opinion. Some scholars they allow it, some scholars they prohibit. And here again you must understand both opinions we must respect. Both opinions we must have respect. Even if you disagree, even if you say, no, I don't disagree with this absolutely. Even you disagree with other. You say, okay, I disagree with that, but I accept that this opinion also is among Muslims, among scholars. Now the opinion, as I said, that I have, I want to mention that, is the use of musical instrument, I do not consider it absolutely prohibited, haram, absolutely prohibited. I do not consider that prohibited, absolutely. It depends. According to my understanding that Allah has given me, and I will mention the ahadith, it depends. It depends on what? It does not depend on the musical instrument. Some scholars, they say it depends on the musical instrument. I disagree with that. I say with respect, I disagree. For me, all musical instruments are the same. Some scholars, they say you can only use daf. Only use daf. Some scholars, they say, no, you can also use other instruments. He did not say only daf is allowed. He never said so. Number two, in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Arabian Peninsula, which musical instruments were found? You will see that guitar was not there. Harmonium was not there. Many other piano was not there. It was not invented to them. They did not have it there. It was not part of the culture. They only had the drum. So they used what they had. And the Prophet ﷺ allowed that. So what happens is that the best understanding is that, as for example, in the time of the Prophet ﷺ, certain things he did not have because of the time, the era, the society he was living in. Transport, for example, we have different means of transport than the time of Rasulullah. It doesn't mean that you can only use that medium of transport of Rasulullah. You can only go on Hajj with a camel, a horse, or a donkey. No. If you have plane, you can go in plane.
If there is a boat, ship, you can go in ship. If you have a camel, you can go with camel. It depends. So the use of musical instruments should not be limited to daf only. Because if you limit it only by daf, using the argument that in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this was only used, nothing else, then you must apply the same ruling on other aspects of Islam, deen as well. Then deen will become difficult to practice. You understand this point? Now the next thing. Which musical instruments are allowed? My view is, any musical instrument is allowed, with provided it is used with good poetry, good text, text that praises Allah and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, text that is good, talks about the blessings of Almighty Allah. And the same thing, if you use musical instrument for anything else, or listen to music that has musical beats and also text that is qabih, evil, Hollywood, the type of music, Bollywood, the type of music, all of that, that talks about the worldly things, haram, the women, the alcohol, all that, drugs, all that is haram. There is no question and debate on that. That is absolutely haram. But when you have music like with Mahir Zain, you have heard of Mahir Zain? You have heard of Sami Yusuf? All these munshids, they use, nasheeds. Sometimes these nasheeds have nothing to do with Allah and the Prophet ﷺ. They are, for example, the love of the mother, or the love for a husband to the wife, which is halal, you know, permissible relation. Then such nasheeds with musical instruments are allowed. But the scholars, they have even then put restrictions. If, like Khwaja Mu'inuddin Chishti Ajmeri, like Imam Ghazali has also allowed to some extent, Imam Ghazali, Nahya al-Ulumuddin, Imam, great Imams, Imam Data Ali Hujwari, they have all spoken and mentioned that the use of music is allowed, but they have set strict restrictions. Their conditions are very strict. Their conditions is, for example, if someone is doing, like in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are using the daf, or they are using musical instrument with nasheed, in that gathering, men and women must not be mixed. They must be separate, sitting to each other. Today, if you look even concerts of Mahir Zain, I was in one of the concerts in Dublin. And when I was there, even though I do listen to nasheeds, when I was there, I said, this is absolutely not allowed. Because there I saw men, women together, women dancing almost, jumping, moving, and the men were looking at them. SubhanAllah, that is what Qadir al-Jilani said, that any gathering where there is ghina, but it is good, like nikah, like marriage ceremony, for example, he says, but it stops you from fulfilling your obligation to Allah, lani salat, and you are so much listening to it that you forget it's time to pray and you delay the prayer. He says, even that normally is allowed, that becomes for you qabih, it becomes not allowed, it becomes evil for you. So you should not then listen to it. So here you see, it depends. For each person, it is different. The use of music is different for each and every person. If a person will not be deviated from the path of Almighty Allah, for him it is permissible. But for a person who, despite listening to nasheed of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like in some qawwali gatherings, I have also heard qawwali gatherings, some naat gatherings, where people are reading naat, mehfili naat, and absolutely, I am not against naat. Naat is ibadah. To praise Rasulullah is ibadah of Almighty Allah. Because Allah has praised Rasulullah. You are fulfilling the sunnah of Allah. But I have seen in gatherings where people are doing whole night in Pakistan, mehfil naat they call it. Which is absolutely great ibadah. But the same ibadah of nafil ibadah, when I see that people, the gathering finishes at 3 o'clock in the morning or 4 o'clock in the morning. And there is only 10-15 minutes left for Fajr prayer. Everybody goes home without praying Fajr. So you see, with any topic like music, there is not a simple answer, yes or no. It's not simple. Even TV, some people say, what is the permissibility of TV? It's not a simple answer. For each person is different. Some people, they will not be tempted to turn on pornographic channels. They will not be tempted at all. They will just watch it for news and that's it. Some people will be tempted to watch music, tempted to watch Bollywood songs, tempted, and this will lead them to what, tempted towards pornography. For such a person, the use of TV is not allowed, not recommended. He should not have a TV in his home. But a person who, for example, he will only use it for Discovery Channel, he will watch news on it, for him, or he will watch dramas that are about his history, his nation's history, but has nothing to do with halal, haram relationships, haram things, for him to use that TV is permissible. So even the TV, it's even internet. It depends. So do not